seed. That's Zii Jia, the only seed through. Very, very surprising. Li Shifeng against Anders Antonsen is tonight. In fact, that's the last match of our second session, which starts at 5 o'clock.
The YONEX All England Open Badminton Championships 2023. Please welcome the number 4 seed from Malaysia, Zii Jia. Giving up for his opponent from China, Shi Yu Qi.
He's had the upper hand in their previous meetings, the Chinese. The confirmation of that 3-1 head-to-head advantage for the Chinese.
Sir. Right side, good luck.
Won the last meeting, which was in the final of the Denmark Open last October.
Four dramatic semi-finals so far on semi-final Saturday.
24 years of age is Li Zii Jia, ranked number 4. He was up at number 2 as recently as last October. Reigning Asian champion, and he won this tournament, the All England, in 2021, where he beat Victor Axelsen in the final. One title last year, that was the Thai Open. But actually, this is a welcome return to form for him. He hasn't been past the second round in the 4 tournaments he's played this year before this week. And there's how he's reached this semi-final, taken to 3 games by Naoki of Japan in the quarters. Fairly straightforward prior to that. And Shi Yu Qi, who's 3 years older than his opponent, ranked at 12, but he was up at number 2 way back August 2017 at high ranking. And he won the All England here in 2018, where he beat Lin Dan in the final. He's also a finalist the year before, and of course a former World Championship silver medalist. Couple of titles on the mantelpiece from last year, the Danish Open, Super 750, and the Australian Open as well. There are his results this week, yet to drop a game, and he took down the number 6 seed, Kunlebut Vititsan, in round 2. Daniel Wolf is the chair umpire for this one, and he'll be supported by Renner Unt of Switzerland. Stand by then for the umpire introductions.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Shi Yu Qi, China. And on my left, Zii Jia, Malaysia. Zii Jia to serve. Love all. Play.
Tough one to call this thing.
I think it comes down to the shot quality of Shi Yu Qi. Can he get just enough quality on so Zii Jia eventually has to hit from positions less optimal, which was one of them. So that Shi Yu Qi's defense can hold up against the fierce attack of the Malaysian.
Certainly trying to put him under pressure early, the Chinese.
Yeah.
Three, one.
Didn't play too well last week in Germany, Shi Yu Qi, but might have been due to jet lag. Whether he can sort of force Zii Jia out of his A game.
Service over. 2-3.
And just to recap the wind conditions here for this fifth match of the early session. I think that Shi Yu Qi is playing with the drift here in the first game and could have trouble being accurate enough with enough pressure on to the backcourt of Zii Jia. So, from Malaysian perspective, there should be all chances that we should get kicking off to a good start on this match. Movement to his big smashes.
Put the crowd with him, that's for sure.
6-4.
Clever to try and put a little deception on the shot to the back line by Shi Yu Qi, but still overdid it. Fit for Zii Jia.
Chance too. Long. So it's Li who has the marginal advantage at the mid-game break.
20 seconds.
Looked on paper like it was going to be a close affair, this, and so far it's exactly how it's turned out. With that shot so far.
Amazing smash he's got, Zii Jia. It's not like Shi Yu Qi hasn't got any defense. It's got normally a very nice defense, the Chinese, but it's really difficult to judge whether it's right or left or body. But look how close this lift from Shi Yu Qi is to the body of Zii Jia. There's no real time to, or room to swing his arm. Great left game.
Yeah, put in touch from Shi.
14-all.
Well, brilliant defence from Lee initially, and then set himself up for the relatively straightforward kill. That was brilliant. Great depth on the left, easy put away.
Side that normally very good variation from Zii Jia did not become dangerous.
That's just near miraculous.
Service over.
To be able to control that like he did. From pretty much on the floor, really. Look to be in control of that round.
Yeah.
Is he coming on strong at just the right time, business end of this opening game?
I think there's a good chance.
And what a time to get it.
Clever play by Shi Yu Qi, knowing that Zii Jia is trying to create opportunities at the net. And then plays it over him with good quality.
Oh.
clever smash. Sliced, had a little bit, so stopped in front of Li Shijia.
Yeah, I think the last, certainly since the mid-game break, it's been Shi Yu Qi who's been dictating most of the rallies.
Close to the net, and then the signature backhand pirouette kill.
So here's the first game point.
Serve is over.
And it goes to the
20.
Chinese.
Game point 19.
It's long, and it's advantage Shi Yu Qi, 21-19 in the opener. He's got a decent record against Li, and he's showing exactly why. The Chinese ahead.
Seconds.
So 22 minutes for that opening game.
Second game.
Shi Yu Qi. Will Li Shijia be able to respond?
Play.
He just looks the sharper of the two to me, Steve, at the moment.
Yeah. It is more all-round Shi Yu Qi, the way I see it. He moves smoother. Li Shijia very, very strong when he's controlling in the attack, and he needs to control now because he's playing with the drift. So again, a battle for the initiative where Shi Yu Qi has the option of playing to the back line, but not too much because that sort of gives away the initiative to Li Shijia. It's an awful sort of return, that one. Qi, one of the players who benefited most from the corona pandemic. Got his ankle fixed. He suffered a bad ankle injury against Anders Antonsen in the Indonesia Open, and couldn't really came back before it had been properly fixed, and was a shadow of himself. But the pandemic gave him time to get it fixed and recover.
Well, that's wonderful play from Zii Jia. He had Shi Yu Qi moving all over the court.
Yeah. The thing is, for attacking players, which is amongst others Li Shijia, it's a little bit easier to play with the drift than if you're not that keen on attacking. So it's too early to write him off yet.
Oh, absolutely. Very tight first game. Second game has begun in similar fashion.
Good shot.
Service over. 4-3.
Just to check that this did clip the line.
I don't think Lee could have walked over there and placed it any better. Well, he could. Wow.
Correction out. Six, three. Play.
That was a surprise. Playing well at the net, Shi Yu Qi. He looks to be in a little bit better position with his body in the majority of the net situations, where we often see Zii Jia fully stretched, like here. Makes it a little bit more difficult to control it well.
For at the moment, is it?
No.
Is he shit?
No.
8-3. Thank you, Michael. Thank you.
Zii Jia not to get too far behind.
Well, that might have been going out. And that was in. Well, in fact, it was called out, but he wants to challenge it, and I don't blame him. I reckon this is very close to that back line. Slightly surprised when the line judge stretched out his arms there. Hawkeye in play again. Yeah.
Oh, that's kind of challenge.
So this is a good little mini comeback from the Malaysian.
Play.
That one was long.
Service over. 9-6.
Six foot one. He's got a great spring as well. And this is that height to full effect.
Ten, six.
Advantage here at the game interval. Look at that. It's anticipating the actions of this jump. Spins way too high. Shot from Malaysian.
Something that's working, Zii Jia.
That one.
12,
way
seven.
Wide. And right now, it looks like that lost first game could become crucial for the Malaysian chances.
Seven.
Well, he keeps giving him these kind of chances, and Shi Yu Qi keeps availing himself of the opportunity.
Yeah. He's playing the front court really well, in my opinion. Shi Yu Qi. Alert to it. Alert to the fact that Zii Jia wants to win the front court to get the lifts. He gets the lift, he just doesn't get enough time to get below it. There he had the patience to wait a little longer in the rally.
Yeah, crowd enjoying his effort. Certainly not going to hand this one on a plate to the Chinese, even though the advantage still 5 points.
Excellent, that's working really well for Zii Jia again. More patience.
11-15.
Much rather play 50-50 in the rally for 10-11 shots than go for the opportunity too early. And getting counter-attacked.
Touch from the Chinese continues to keep 60. The Malaysian at arm's length here in this second game.
Zii Jia was quick on that one.
Yeah. 18. 11.
This is the time where it's now or never. One suspects for Zii Jia.
Well, that's a good way to start a comeback, but he's got a fair way to go.
12-18.
For a place in the final. He just needed one of them. Pretty comprehensive, you'd have to say, in that second game. The Chinese was excellent, very consistent, very few errors. And Li Zijie just couldn't live with him today, Steve.
No, the important phase from 15-17 in the first game when Shi Yu Qi took that, then it was too difficult for Li Shijia to come back here in the second. The serve win for Shi Yu Qi. What a triumph for him to be back in the final of the All England.
Won this title in 2018, as I mentioned, when he beat Lin Dan in the final. Now he's got a chance to be a two-time All-England champion. Just a barrage of winners, really, from Shi Yu Qi today. Very, very impressive. Nod of respect there from Zii Jia at the end. So the final result, 21-19, 21-13, 42 minutes, the match time. So recapping what we've seen today, victory by 2-0 in the women's doubles, unsurprisingly for Beck and Lee, looking to back up their win in Germany last weekend. Zheng and Huang just about coming through in 2 games in the mixed doubles. And then a bit of a shock, Akane Yamaguchi in the women's singles, losing 2-0 to Chen Yufei, although it appeared the Japanese might have some kind of shoulder injury. Then we saw a dramatic men's doubles with the veterans Arsene and Setiawan coming through 29-27 in the third against the young Chinese pair Liang and Wang. And then, as you've just seen, a pretty bloodless victory, really, for Shi Yu Qi. Straight games, only 43 minutes against Li Zii Jia. Just a reminder that our second session begins at 5 o'clock. This will be in the company of Jill Clark and Chris Langridge. You can pick out your favourite matches there. That women's singles looks a belter, doesn't it? Tai Zi Ying against An Se Young for the right to play Chen Yufei tomorrow. And of course, the other men's single semi will be on the programme as well. That'll be match number 10 Li Shifeng against Anders Antonsen. That all starts in just under 2 hours' time. For now, though, I hope you've enjoyed our coverage on semi-final Saturday. For me, Trevor Harris, for Steve Pedersen, and our whole cast and crew in Birmingham. We'll see you a bit later tonight. For now, bye-bye.